In this video, we'll cover how you can connect to your KNIME server from KNIME Analytics Platform to upload and execute workflows on KNIME server and make use of all the additional functionality, such as the KNIME web portal, versioning, remote and scheduled execution, to name just a few. In the upper left corner of KNIME Analytics Platform, you can find the KNIME Explorer. From here, you can connect to the examples server and the KNIME hub. In addition, you can see all your projects or workflows under the local mount point. Server connections in KNIME Analytics Platform are additional mount points in your KNIME Explorer. Click the Configure the Visible Content of the Explorer View option in the upper right of the KNIME Explorer to edit current mount points and add new ones. Here you can see a list of all the configured mount points. By selecting or deselecting, you can define which are displayed in the KNIME Explorer. Use the buttons on the right to define the order, edit an existing mount point, and add new ones. Click New to configure a new mount point with your server details. We have two options for mount points, KNIME Server Space and KNIME Community Server. The Community Server is for developers writing community nodes who use this server for testing. In this video, however, we want to focus on the KNIME Server Space. After selecting the KNIME Server Space option, fill in the correct server address, login credentials, and the name of the mount ID if desired. The Use REST option enables KNIME to communicate with the server via REST protocol. We recommend this since it's faster than the legacy option, which is retained for compatibility for the time being. Now click Apply and Close to add to the new mount point, as you can see here. To now connect to the server, you can either double-click or right-click the mount point and select Connect to Server. Next, you have to provide your username and password. Once you're connected, you'll see the shared repository with all the items located on the server for which you have access. This means workflows, workflow groups, files, and components. Now that the connection is established, we can deploy content from our local workspace to this server. Right-click a workflow you wish to deploy and select the option Deploy to Server. In this dialog, we can select our specified server and workflow group, resetting the workflow if we want before deploying. Additionally, any workflow group, data files, or any other files necessary to operate your workflows can be copied to the server by copying the local files, shared components and workflow groups, and pasting them into the desired location on the server. Now it's over to you to connect to your server and deploy your workflows, workflow groups, files and components. We hope this video was useful to get you started.